Hi, I'm Tom Hinton with the 10,000 Days Foundation, and I have the pleasure of speaking with Dr. Dolores Fazzino. She is a registered nurse and has her doctorate in nursing as well. She's an accomplished author, and tell us a little bit about your new book.
Oh, my new book is called Spiritual Wellness for Life, and it is about stories from my personal and professional life where there has basically been what we call a God moment, where things kind of just, spirit came in and kind of did some invisible work, and a magical event or experience has transpired. A lot of times in life, I think people have very similar situations, but yet they're afraid to talk about them. Mm-hmm. Because there's like a little, you know, taboo, or people are like, oh, what is everybody going to think when I share this story? But, you know, when people do share those stories, it's very transformational and healing for the person who shares it. And additionally, a lot of times, that little piece of information that they're sharing is a puzzle piece to help somebody else.
Now, in your book, which I've read and I highly recommend, you talk about both the traditional Western medicine mm-hmm. blended with, you don't quite refer to it as the Eastern medicine, well, explain that a little bit.
I am a bridge person. I combine Western medicine. I'm Western medicine trained, but I'm also been dabbling in alternative and complementary modalities probably my whole entire life, and that's many decades. And so I find that bridging the two together actually helps people in their healing process. Mm-hmm. As a registered nurse and a nurse practitioner for the last 35 years, I've witnessed people creating diseases for themselves. And we in the Western medicine have a tendency to throw Band-Aids on things, cut things out, throw a Band-Aid, give a pill or whatever, instead of really looking at the underlying issue of what really created the physical disease. It could have been something you either believed in, or something that was told to you, or, you know, your thought process. It could be environmental too, but, you know, I don't put a lot of emphasis on the environmental. I really think a lot of times people just have stinking thinking, and this creates a lot of issues for themselves. Yeah. But also, what I'm finding over my tenure in healthcare is that Western medicine is starting to embrace the whole mind-body concept, but what's really missing is the spirituality.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I feel that spirituality is the glue that holds the body, mind, and soul together. It's essential. If you don't have that component to it, I don't really feel people will be at their true best.
Now, you're going to be speaking at a number of the 10,000 Days Foundation events. We're delighted to have you.
Well, thank you.
Share with our viewers, what are some of the takeaways that they can expect from your presentations?
Well, I really like to focus on what I call the keys of spiritual wellness. And this information I was able to grasp on a recent trip to Brazil, that when I was in meditation, this information came to me. And so I sat down and wrote it down. And there's seven spiritual keys to wellness. And a lot of them are not what you think they are. But what we're going to do in our little talk is I'll probably take three of those and do some little experiential exercises so people can get a flavor of what that's all about. And just, you know that they could do these things rather quickly. Mm-hmm. Interestingly enough, I'm of the philosophy that less is more, mm-hmm. and that, you know, making things more complicated is more of an ego-based thing versus like being connected with your heart-centered self and being in present moment, which is a very simple and easy thing to do.
Yeah. And if people want to know more or get a copy of your book, what's the best way to reach you, Dolores?
Well, my book's available on Amazon, and my website is www.spiritualwellnessforlife.com. And I also could be reached at 760-579-2440.
Wonderful. We look forward to having you with us. Thanks so much.
Thank you, Tom.
Thanks.
It's a pleasure.